25 जून न भूलने वाला दिवस है। भारत के लोकतंत्र पर जो काला धब्बा लगा था उसके 50 वर्ष हो रहे हैं कि भारत के संविधान को पूरी तरह नकार दिया गया था, संविधान के लीरे लीरा उड़ा दिए गए थे, देश को जेल खाना बना दिया गया था, लोकतंत्र को पूरी तरह दबोच दिया गया था। देशवासी संकल्प लेंगे कि भारत में फिर कभी कोई ऐसी हिम्मत नहीं करेगा जो 50 साल पहले की गई थी और लोकतंत्र पे काला धब्बा लगा दिया गया था।
1975, 25th June was a day which was marked as a dark spot or a black spot in the Indian democracy. That's the charge the BJP has been making ever since that day as well. In fact, even though the Congress party has come out and apologized for the emergency, the BJP seems to be in no mood to let go of that issue. And year after year, you've seen the BJP top leadership remind the people of the country as to how freedom of media and freedom generally was curbed by Indira Gandhi during that time as well. Several leaders within the BJP ranks, whether it's Rajnath Singh, Arun Jaitley or the others, they all went and spent months in jail fighting the emergency as well. Cut to the modern day, as we see that today is the 50th anniversary of the emergency period. The BJP has in fact organized a protest all over the country. They've in fact organized programs all over the country. The party's national president, Mr. JP Nadda, will be holding a big program on the occasion at the party's national headquarters. On the other side, the opposition parties have in fact come out in parliament with a copy of the constitution, reminding the BJP of the properties of the constitution and what its duty and what its implications really are, because they feel that the modern day emergency is more dangerous than the emergency of 1975. They basically feel that the BJP has cramped all the institutions across the country, whether it's the election commission, whether it's the courts of the country, or even parliament for that matter as well. A strong opposition was registered by the India Bloc leaders, given the fact that K. Suresh, who is an 8-time member of parliament, was not given the pro-term seat, and obviously because he was a Dalit, he was being targeted. That's been the charge of the opposition parties as well. Yesterday, even when the Prime Minister was taking oath as an MP in the Lok Sabha, Rahul Gandhi showed him a copy of the constitution, and that seems to be the mood that the opposition parties are really in. They've been telling the people of the country that, you know, if the BJP gets 400, probably the BJP will amend the constitution. That actually cut ice with a lot of people, because we saw the drop as far as the number of seats of the BJP is concerned in poll-bound states during the Lok Sabha elections as well. So obviously, face-off once again will continue today in Parliament as the BJP and the opposition come face-to-face. Given the fact that today is the second day of the oath-taking, the larger focus will be on members who have to take oath, which also includes the likes of Rahul Gandhi, Akhilesh Yadav, Dimple Yadav, Abhishek Banerjee, amongst the others as well. And of course, the BJP will continue to remind the Congress party through its various initiatives. We've seen the Prime Minister come out and really put out a tweet, damning the emergency period that was imposed. Party's National President JP Nadda has also come out and spoken about this. But, P. Chidambaram, the former finance minister, has also countered this and essentially told the government to consider its impact and consider its role in the modern day and probably help the people of the country as well. So the face-off, which has continued over the last few years, also will continue today and in more in the times to come.